are presented with an opportunity to seize greatness. In beautiful Southern California, the PGF Championships introduce that opportunity of a lifetime. It's North America's best of the best. It's a celebration of the sport, and a champion is crowned now.
And that'll do it. Oh, celebrate. Out of North San Diego, Breakers Labs wins it all. The 16U Platinum Division 2022 PGF Champs.
And on the banks of the Pacific, let's do this amazing event again. And let's do it out of the gates at the 16U Age Group from Irvine, California at beautiful Bill Barber Park. It's the PGF National Champions, the 16U Platinum Division. Breakers Labs defeated the Ohio Hawks last year. This year, it's the shocking Utah Freaks in their very small roster against a national team based in Kentucky, that Fusion team. Hi there, folks. Oh, it's so good to be back. Amanda Freed, Olympic gold medalist, national champion. My name is Darren Sutton. Thanks for spending time with all of us and these great athletes. The bottom line is you move up. If you win at the Platinum Division, you're automatically in the Premier next year. There's a lot more at stake than that, but that's a big part of it.
Oh my gosh, what a tremendous opportunity for these groups. And how about the representation across the country with Utah and Kentucky here in this national championship? And these teams have fought through this week to get to where they are. There's a lot on the line, but you know, Fusion undefeated. The Freaks had to come out of that what-if game, and they're here to compete and hopefully win that premier berth.
Yeah, they've been an if the whole time when you look at the Freaks, and they'll tell you that. With Quinn at the very top, Rayleigh Shields right behind, Brooklyn Ricci is in the bottom spot of that three-hole. Addison Comer, Eliza Johnson, Ella Miller, Brielle Sandoval, Athena Tonganovai, and Macy Madsen. On down the Utah Freaks. A lot of base in Salt Lake. And let's meet Sadie Winsett. She's in the circle for the Fusion national team. Reed, Satterley, Ware, and Jones surround her on the infield. Pryor is her battery mate. And again, this is the first event. We're kicking it off. It's a busy weekend. This is week number one. This is the premier, the number one softball event on the planet in North America. College coaches, certainly with the athletes being protected at a younger age, are all over this event.
Oh, these are the types of teams you want to watch, knowing what they came through the week, the kind of competition that they've been playing, and the grit it takes to get to this point. You want to be watching this game.
Well, let's play. And you think we're excited? You're going to be excited as you enjoy it as the first pitch dips just a little bit low to Ainsley Quinn. She's from Magna, Utah, Cypress High School. She's a 2024 grad, would love to go to the College of Southern Idaho or Oregon. A couple of her dream schools, as that one splits the plate 1-1. She's gotten a lot of tips from college players as she heads into this ever-important September 1 time where she can talk to coaches.
Yeah, so many of these athletes haven't yet given their verbal commitment to go off and play college.
Bouncing ball, middle of the diamond, scatters on into center field, and that's a base hit to start things for Ainsley Quinn, the left fielder. We told you about the infield that's working behind Sadie Winsett. Allow us to introduce you to all of them. Caitlin Whitlock is in left field. Jayla Manning is in center field. Aubrey Bratson, right. The infield that we shared with you, and again, Peyton Pryor, her battery man working behind her. Braylon Shields now. Shields, high sky, left side. The talented athlete out of Riverton, Utah. Whitley Hammond High School at Riverton High School. Whitley is her head coach. Just one pitch and a quick out. That leaves Quinn stuck at first for the time being anyway. So they get Shields.
Number 22, Brooklyn Ricci.
Brooklyn Ricci takes just off the plate outside. Now this is a wonderful opportunity for her. Dad is the head coach. She plays volleyball, soccer. She swims competitively as well. Grounds that one, could be two. Takes a high, tough hop. Nice adjustment just to get one out. Addison Ware, suddenly that went from belt up above her chest, and it made it a very tough play. Nice job sticking with it by Addie.
Yeah, and that's a critical play. Goes for that short out at second base, has to stay in front of it, takes that high hop, but keeps her body in front of it to get that first out. Nice adjustment there on the infield.
From Holiday, Utah, this is Addie Comer, and she takes a pitch over the outside corner. Pretty curveball, dips outside, 0-1 the count. This is a gifted outfielder. She's a 2025. Give her her choice. She'd love to go to Utah State or BYU. 1-1 the count. She said, my summer has been so fun. I've learned more this year than I ever have in my life playing this sport. A lot of it's grit, a lot of it's trusting teammates. She told herself to celebrate the little things like base hits. Celebrating the little things, and it helps when you pitch in a hit. The number four hitter and the center fielder, Addison Comer, with a single. That moves Ricky up to second base.
Well, you can tell this is a very tight-knit team. It's a thin team. Not a lot of depth on the bench, but that means you've got to pull your weight and rely on your teammates, a lot of trust. Keep plugging away. Base hits like this fall.
Eliza Johnson attends Olympus High School. Elevated that one back behind home plate. Peyton Pryor sticks with it and puts it away. That allows Sadie Winsett to put up a clean zero on the board and pass the torch to her mates to swing the bat. We've just gotten started at the PGF 16 Youth Platinum. Lucy Evans working in the circle for the Utah Freaks. The Fusion National lineup that she will deal with has Addison Ware at the top. The second baseman, Caitlin Whitlock, Jayla Manning, Lauren Satterley. It's Madison Reed, Aubrey Batts, the right fielder. Peyton Pryor has done the catching, a couple of nice plays that last inning. Aubrey Wright and Lily Jones on down to the bottom of the order. Meet Lucy Evans, who works in the circle. She's from Spanish Fork, Utah, Weber State, BYU, Stanford, a couple of schools she'd love to attend. Not only is she talented, but this is a 30 ACT, 4.0 GPA, so she's recruitable.
Absolutely. Coaches love to see those academic numbers as they know they can rely on them to get it done in the classroom. And
slaps it the other way. Defense perfectly. They had her swung that way. Ainsley Quinn trickled on in, and part of anchoring the defense in left field is Quinn. Her mates, Comer in center field, Shields is in right. Tonganovai is the third baseman. Sandoval Johnson Miller with Brooklyn doing the catching. There's Addison, or Ainsley, I should say. Caitlin with a bat in her hands now. Off the glove of the third baseman, can't find it, now recovers. She was already playing tight for the slapper, but Athena just couldn't come up with it. Tonganovai tried to recover, just couldn't.
Yeah, look at her creeping up that line. That was some great contact and a nice job of knocking it down. This almost gets past Athena at third. Pops right up. It's a lot of speed. Whitlock showing down the line.
Jayla Manning.
From Louisville, Kentucky is Jayla Manning. He's at Louisville Male High School. She'd love to go to Western Kentucky or Kentucky. Maybe Louisville, some of her top choices. Donald Murphy's her high school coach. I'm sure proud of what she's accomplishing. And this season, leading the team with a 457 clip. Mom is Jessica, her stepdad is Wes, and her dad is Ricole. She's got a very young sister at home, just one, little Hadley, who's gonna be watching this one's every move. Bouncing that one, tried to sneak it, that's a fair ball, great recovery, but she legs it out. Call made from behind home plate. It hadn't crossed the bag at third yet, so right on top of it, making that call. And another good, quick reaction.
That's a great snag right on the line. But Manning did a good job of not questioning fair or foul. She just took off speed down the line and beat that throw.
From Taylorsville, Kentucky, meet Lauren Satterley. Number 00 on that jersey, left-handed bat at Assumption High School. Suzanne Cates, her coach. Is there someone to get to the bag? There is. Well, she caught it so quickly, turned around, and again, we're seeing some great work by Tonganovai out there at third base. Sandoval trickled in and stepped on the bag, the shortstop.
Yeah, Tonganovai is really being tested at third base. A couple of hot shots, and then having to make some quick decisions. She knows exactly where the play is. That's a great job Sandoval does of going over and receiving that throw on the run.
I'm sorry, you have to be just a little bit fearless to play that position tight. That's part of the assignment. And you know the assignment as it's popped up to the right side. Miller in foul territory, right behind her, Eliza Johnson, the second baseman, unable to make the play. Athena at third has been just gutsy as can be. As Utah team, a great story. The Fusion team, a great story as well, as we have gotten to watch them and what they have accomplished. Saw Jennifer Hunt, the head coach, 16U age group for 3 years. Played collegiate baseball at Bellarmine University. Madison Reed, 8 runs batted in, and OPS, they call it a one dot. When you're over 1,000, that's pretty darn good. Right-handed bat, slightly open stance. And takes outside. Brooklyn with a good firm throwback to her pitcher there. We need to get 2 radar guys. Changed up, it floated high. Now tried to sneak a throw behind.
Yeah, I like it. It looked like that pitch before when she fired it back to Evans. Looked like a kind of a fake out pickoff at second base.
I think so. I think it was.
Yeah, and then she showed off her arm on that one.
Reed, the daughter of Natalia and Daniel. And the big sis to Shelby and Georgia, who are 15 and 12. That's wide in the center field. It's down for a base hit. The Fusion pushing the envelope. They jump on top. 1-0 with a head first slide. Is there a second run? As Saturday really took a chance. Gutsy stuff.
Yeah, Fusion really making the Freaks throw that ball around. This is a nice swing ball up the middle. So you think, okay, a short first run, even though that throw was strong and on the money, then the throw down to second and then back home, but aggressive base running all around to score 2 runs.
This is a young player, Aubrey Batts. What a great opportunity for her as she takes right down the middle. And we're talking about this coaching staff, Jennifer Hunt, Shannon Surley, Andy Joe Pryor. There's Jennifer. National champions, runner-up second year, PGF playing for a national championship as well. This Fusion 16U national team. That's a 2026. Batts lines that one into left field again. Nice job defensively hauling it in. Look, they did a great job, by the way, defensively, the Freaks, but it was just one big piece of hitting by Madison Reed and then wildly aggressive base running. Not just Manning scoring, but Satterley as well. Oh, 0-0. Individual stats, right? But you love a teammate who grabs you an RBI with aggressive base running. We understand that it's about the team thing. But I'd be smiling too if I had that kind of help. That's Madison Reed, the third baseman. It was Lauren Satterley who had a guts of a thief coming on down and scoring that second run as The relay was tossed in, tried to make it close. Fun stuff, great energy.
Number 17, Ella Miller.
Sadie Winsett in the circle has something to work with now. Ella Miller will lead it off, the first base. Talented athlete. Winsett, by the way, is from Newburgh, Indiana. She works in the circle. Is it 2025? How about Indiana? How about WKU, which is Western Kentucky, or Florida Atlantic? A couple of places she'd like to go. And she's talking about her recruiting process, Amanda, as talented pitcher. She said, my best way to handle things and learn more without communicating directly, which she can do September 1, has been going to camps, emailing coaches. They don't respond, but they know what I'm doing.
You know, and it's one of those games that you have to do as an athlete. You have to keep reaching out, keep plugging away, because then coaches really know that you care, and then you're on it. And it's not just that you're throwing email out to everybody. You want to make them know that you're really interested in their program.
Boy, pretty piece of hitting down for a base hit. How far does it roll? It's cut off out there. Ella Miller, great extension, using the bigger part of the field for a single.
That's a great piece of hitting. And that's also visiting those college campuses, going back to that, is the best way for those coaches to get to know you as a person, because they can talk to you. And then, obviously, they see that athletic ability. What a beautiful swing going right side.
Riel Sandoval from Price, Utah, Carbon High School. Looking back behind home plate, that one ends up getting some iron, and it's a foul ball. Briel would love to play someday at the college level. How about UCLA or Oregon, a couple of places she'd love to go to. Drops down a pretty bunt. Dies out in front of home plate, moves that runner into scoring position. Miller to second. Sandoval with the sack bunt.
Yeah, doing her job. Beautiful sacrifice bunt.
From third base, number 15.
And when it's this early in the ball game, you can play for that one run. One run at a time. There's still a lot of innings left.
Vina Tonganavai from Bountiful, Utah. Bountiful High School. Which ladies are head coach. That's popped up behind home plate. Peyton Pryor, for the second time, has a put out in this game. And they managed to get Athena, who's been so strong at third, Ulysses Sotelo, her parents.
Designated player, number 24, Macy Madsen.
Macy Madsen, her chance now. 1-0 the count on a changeup. Macy's from Riverton High School in Utah. Riverton, Utah. Destiny and Eric, her parents. It's a 4.0 student. Hits it in the center field. Trying to get one back. Drawing a throw to the plate. The relay. Not in time. Runner will move into scoring position. The number 9 hole hitter for the Utah Freaks comes up with a huge 2-out RBI. 2-1.
Clutch hitting early in this ball game on both sides. This, a nice swing. Look at that contact right up the middle. Miller rounding hard. You've got to take a chance on this, and it pays off.
Number 27, Ainsley Quinn.
Ainsley Quinn. 1-0 the count to Ainsley. She singled back in the first inning. Dad played college baseball, pitched at the college level. Her dad, Rick. That screwball runs high and inside, 2-0 the count. And Ainsley, one of those athletes that has grown as a softball player because she's played other sports, played very competitive basketball up until a couple of years ago, then she backed off. So the one big thing I learned about basketball, maybe different than softball, is how to communicate. It's constant, it's ongoing, you have to. So that helped me as a softball player. Great at bat, those were just a notch above the hitting zone.
You know, and that's something that I've really noticed throughout this week is, I'm not gonna say a tight zone, but it's reflective of the college strike zone. It's right. Very tight, you have to find it. And those pitches to me look amazing, but it's consistently not being called a strike. So early in the ball game, a lot of times pitchers are just trying to find how far outside you can inch to get those strikes.
Got a strike that time. Nice job stealing it. Peyton Pryor framed it up. I think more than anything, too, watching Quinn's patience as we see Shields now, is those pitches are tantalizing. And a little bit of spin on those rise balls, that's what happens up in the air, and that hangs up very nicely. They look good, but then when you take a pass at them, you're underneath them, and you're an out in the air. A two-out RBI off the bat of Macy Matson. The Freaks pull closer out of Utah. It's 2-1. Is there a more beautiful destination than Southern California, especially this time of year where a lot of the country's hot and uncomfortable, not out here. Get that ocean breeze coming in and you're enjoying watching the best players on the planet play this sport. At the 16U age group, Peyton Pryor leads it off for the Fusion national team. Skies that one up over our head. 1-0 the count. Amanda Freed, Darren Sutton, and you. And the great PGF leadership worked tirelessly. So many regional and local events, certainly. But an opportunity to really flex who you are. Pryor takes that one just a little bit low. Peyton Pryor's Randy Joe is her big sister. Heading into her junior year at Indiana State, an alum. They lost Ashton Pryor, and it's just heartbreaking what they've been through as this one is into center field. Ashton was part of the team for 2 years on the Fusion 18U national team. Tragically lost her life in a car accident in February. Was an ISU commit, headed to play with Sis. Her pink jerseys with writing of her name and a number across the heart.
Designated player.
Live like Ashton Pryor is their motto. This tournament's for her and Peyton and RJ and the Pryor family. That's who they play for. Makes this run very, very special. Can't imagine. As that screwball hits the inside corner. The siblings, the parents. Can't imagine being a parent losing your child.
No, I don't think there would be anything more tragic than that. To be honest, having kids and the thought of that, but also, you know, having this family to kind of rely on for support, I think has been key. I'm sure the family would attest to the organization, what they've been able to do and be for the Pryors during this tragic time.
Aubrey Wright can catch, thrown out nearly half the runners that have tried to steal against her. At a 433 on base in this tournament. Well, that's a pretty curveball, too. 1-2 the count. She's got six RBIs as well, Aubrey. From Louisville, Kentucky, Oldham County High School. Elevated. Rise ball. That'll do it. She spun one away a moment ago, and that kind of set the line of sight out there. Then she went up here.
Yeah, a really nice sequence of pitches, and that's the first strike out of this ball game. We've seen a lot of nice, solid contact. With that rise ball up in the zone, gets the first K.
LJ, Lily Jones. It's a pitch, pretty good pitch. I think if she holds on, Brooklyn, it's called a strike. How about Murray State? She'd love to play there. How about Northern Kentucky as her teammates look on? Love to play at Bellarmine as well. And emailing coaches and schools and attending camps. This is 2025, so she's just about a month away from all those communications. The daughter of Jeanette and Jason. Mom, college volleyball player, played for a couple of years at Georgetown College. And she played it quite a bit. Just actually stopped playing volleyball, Lily. Miss Lily. The 1-1. Oh, she's effective up there, isn't she? We talked about the patience as they were watching Winston go up there and take. These aren't takes.
I was just thinking that same thing. That pitch looks so good to swing at. And you know when you connect solid, it goes a long way. But if you get under just a little bit, you've got a pop-up.
Turn that one over. Good screwball. Looking to get a ground ball with that pitch.
Come on,
skies that one foul. Battled quite an illness, having gastroparesis, making it difficult to gain weight and just wanting to be an athlete, get stronger, and has pushed through it. She said, but it was scary for a while, having, you know, to go through that internally. Paige Murphy, her hitting coach, watching this one closely. But she hits it hard toward the hole, played on a backhand long. Past the diamond. Brielle Sandoval flexing that arm. Right behind, talking to Mai. That's an outstanding play. You know what else that is, folks? That's a 1-2-3 inning. Gotta love your defenders.
Check, check. Yep. Awesome. Awesome.
I do. Yep. Yes.
I do. Yes, I do. Okay.
Talented team out of Utah, and their opportunity now to swing the bats. And it's Ricky, Comer, and Johnson. Utah Freaks, Anthony Ricky, Rick Quinn, the coaching staff. You love the berm. Nothing better than taking it in with it, especially when there's a breeze blowing and it feels like it's just a slice of heaven out there as that curveball disappears outside. 0-1 the count to Brooklyn Ricky. Older brother is Jacob, he's 20. We told you Anthony is head coach, that's dad, as that changeup skips on in there. Andrea's mom. She gives a lot of credit to her time in the pool. Competitive swimming really helped with her endurance. As that one grabs the inside corner. There's Anthony. Screen it goes. Anthony's a head softball coach locally in Utah at Hillcrest High School. He's the football assistant coach. He looks like he could be a lineman on the football team. I'm yes sir, no sir when I bump into him later. Boy, great change of pace. Really leaked out front. Out of the circle comes Sandy and she makes the play for the out. You love when a hitter has to give themselves up like this.
Yeah, you're in protect mode with two strikes. And if you're a pitcher who can throw that changeup for a strike, that's a little elevated, but that can be very effective as well. If you get out on that front foot and the barrel drops, this is what happens, a little miss hit.
Eddie now. And fouled back, tried to pull the string again. Right, you don't want to live up there with the changeup, but more than anything, it's just a change in velocity that makes it effective.
Absolutely. Yeah, if you're effective, I tell my pitchers, I don't care where you throw the changeup a lot of time. If you can throw it effectively with a quick arm speed and make it look like all your other pitches, go for that strike zone every time. Don't try to put it outside. And good things happen. Even if it elevates a little, if you catch a hitter off guard, you're going to get a miss hit.
Well, to your point, you're going to get uncomfortable contact. You may not get that dreamy swing and miss, but you're going to get the contact like we saw a moment ago. Homer lifts that one foul off to the left side.
Hey, watch it. Is it rolling off? Well, I don't know.
Daughter of Camille and Dave Comer. Dad was a diver, very successful competitive diver up into college. Mom, a gymnast. Bouncing ball, slow roller, ranging over to her left is Madison Reed. 5-3 ground out. That one got on top of the dirt and flattened out.
It was another changeup down in the zone. This one really well placed out front off the end of the bat.
Number two.
Reed does a good job of sweeping across to get that out.
Pride of Olympus High School, Eliza Johnson now. Nice play out there. She said, this summer I've learned to live in the moment and stay positive. I didn't always do that in the past, the daughter of Sherilyn and Blake. Well, that's a screamer. I mean, you've got to stay positive, though you're frustrated. I squared you up, Sadie. How in the world is that not a base hit? But this pretty swing. I'd be positive about that. But if I'm Sadie, I'm happy too.
What makes the Thunderbolt?
18 new Platinum Championship games. Certainly they get set. The Atlanta Vipers, Colorado Stars. Last year it was Rock Gold out of Fort Myers, Florida winning, beating the Minnesota Renegades. Freed, you and I have talked about it. This, when it was built, and this event started overall back in 2010 and then started to grow with more and more age groups in the Premier than Platinum. But seeing a team from Atlanta, that was back to the screen off the bat of Addison Ware for Fusion National. Even the last year, just at the 16 and 18 Platinum. Breakers Labs out of San Diego, Ohio Hawks from the Ohio area, Fort Myers and Minnesota. Right there, those four different areas of the country. This was kind of a primary SoCal event when it started. Pretty bunt, tough to play, no play at all. Athena's been dependable out there at third base. Nothing she could have done, though.
Now, even if you're charging hard, that was too well placed and too much speed. Look at how this ball just dies.
Now batting, left fielder, number three, Caitlin Whitlock.
Caitlin Whitlock now out of Sellersburg, Indiana. Through that one, lifts it off to the left side, drifting back to shortstop, Riel Sandoval. One out here in the third inning with a runner on first.
Now at the plate, center fielder, number 22.
Jayla Manning Jayla now.
Manning.
Five sports have been a part of her evolution, including in that volleyball, basketball, running track, soccer, then softball. Thrown down on a hop, that one skipped right on through. Ricky with a good firm throw, but there's a stolen base. We saw the aggression in the first inning of this Fusion team running the bases. It's back again.
Yeah, forcing throws. Speed is so important.
Well, that's a great look, that camera, isn't it? Right down the pipe at that smile as she anticipates things. Hit on a line, is it two? Unable to get to the bag. A great approach for Manning, but it was right to Sandoval, Riel Sandoval, the shortstop.
Now batting shortstop, 00, Lauren Satterley.
Only caught once this year. 23 stolen bases for Addison Ware. Lauren Satterley. Owen buzzes her tower. She spins out of the way.
You can see Ware out there on second base getting a track lead. Knee down, hand down. I mean, she's scoring on anything.
One and one the count on Satterley. He's out of Taylorsville, Kentucky. Jeremy and Heather, her parents. He's a 4.0 student, principal's on a roll. He finds the hole in right field, charging hard as Shields. The throw to the plate, not in time. Another run for Fusion. They lead it 3-1 in the Platinum Championship game at the 16U age group.
Another two-out RBI. Squared up nicely, pulls it. And we talked about Ware being ready to score on anything. She's off hardly a hesitation on contact as she's rounding head for home.
Madison Reed drove in a couple of runs back in the first inning. Had a two-out RBI. Boy, they're aggressive on the base pads. Wow, over the top. Had to hurdle the defender who came on in Sandoval, and there was just no way Satterlee was not getting to that bag. Watch this.
That would have been really interesting had the ball been caught and applied cleanly. That's such a tough, it looks like the cleatle. That would knock the ball out.
It did. Fearless, fearless on the bases. Change up, good take. So Madison had one of my favorite answers, and we'll wax and we'll talk about the other sports that the athletes play and how much it helps them. But she said simply, I played soccer when I was five, but I got hit in the head and I quit. That's it. High fly ball center field. Keep it simple, we always say. Not everything needs to have honey dripping off of it. If it hits you in the head, don't play anymore. Big add-on run, 3-1, Fusion on top. Fusion on top of Utah, the Utah Freaks by a score of 3-1. Jennifer Hunt joins us, the head coach of this Fusion team. Jennifer, thanks for spending time with us. We really appreciate it.
Of course. Thanks for having us.
Oh, you lovely players. Aren't they fun that they're having with you?
I'm doing my best to stay up
straight. You're doing a very, very good job. Former college catcher, would you have liked to have dealt with your team on the base pads, as they are really aggressive, Jennifer?
Absolutely not. We live and die by our base running, so we just kind of give them the freedom to make their own decisions and the freedom to fail, and so they're super aggressive.
Well, and then defensively, in the circle, shutting it down, Winsett's doing such a nice job. Talk a little bit about her performance today. Just overall, what's been going on in your circle this week?
Pure confidence. She wants the ball. She wants the ball. She wants to be on the mound. She loves these big situations. So we have full trust in her.
Describe the experience this week for your athletes, the growth that it provides, the memories too.
It's been a grind. I think this is our 11th game, so it's been an absolute grind. So it's more, you know, more than just the talent. You've got to have the grit and the determination and just the selfless play. I think that's been the difference. We've had them, you know, buy into the culture and just playing for each other and playing for something bigger, and they bought in, and I think that's where the magic happens.
I'm loving the visual on this. We'll let you go back to work. Thank you so much. Congratulations. You look like a walking sporting goods store.
Thank you for having us. I appreciate
it. Thank you, Jennifer. Good luck.
Thank you. Oh,
that's impressive.
That is impressive.
What was on there?
Number 15. Sky, shallow left, back of short, in and out of the glove, unfortunately, of Lauren Satterlee, the shortstop. With three Fusion that came together to attempt to make that play, and Satterlee couldn't make it.
And in my mind, I was just thinking about how solid Satterlee was and is at shortstop, making some really nice plays, and she has to go a long way from for this ball. Whitlock and Manning and the outfield are playing fairly deep, so everyone had to run a long way.
Vina Tonganavai takes a pitch that is high, 1-0 the count. That's the kind of situation where if you're Utah, the Salt Lake City-based team, you got to cash in. This is a relentless team you're playing. They're matching in hits. They each have four hits apiece. So that one dots the outside corner. Athena popped up to the catcher back in the second inning. Any hitter will tell you. Any at bat that you have, when you pop up to the catcher, you can't wait till your next at bat. You just soon strike out, then pop up to the catcher. Hits it hard on the ground. A little backhanded flip. Look at it, 2-2. How about you? A double play. It's Ware to Satterlee, who gets another chance, and a nice quick turnover over to Lily Jones. All those gloves that were stacked on top of Jennifer's head. They went to work right in the middle of the field. We'll stack them on your head coach's head if you make a play like that.
You're good,
whatever great story this Utah Freaks team has been snatching victories away from other teams. Their head coach is Anthony Ricci, who spends time with us down inside that dugout. Anthony, you guys have just been dramatically fun in order to get here, haven't you?
Oh, it's been awesome.
Tell us a little bit about this week, what it's meant to you and your athletes, the memories and the experiences.
We're never going to forget getting here. The journey to get here, there's an easy way and the hard way, and luckily for us, we took it the easy way.
Well, and talk a little bit about this game right now. I mean, your team's settling in, getting it done defensively. Your pitcher, Lucy Evans, in the circle, doing a tremendous job. How proud are you of the team that's performing out there on the field today?
Oh, I'm super proud. You know, we roll down here with 11 players, and we're using them all and doing what we need to do to get the job done.
Tell us a little bit about your program as it pertains to who you are, your guys' identity, who you are locally, because you really are a true Utah team.
We are. You know, when I came over in 2019, October 2019, I had a pitcher and a catcher, and I asked another gentleman who ran the Utah Freaks. I said, hey, are you willing to start a 14U team? And from there, we've been going. So this is the fourth year.
So many memories. By the way, football coaching on your resume as well, too?
Yeah, I'm missing some football right now.
You are. You look like you could still play, Coach.
I try to, and I actually had a fracture in my foot from thinking I could run with the boys.
Uh-oh. Well, listen, best of luck to you. This has been a blast to cover your team. Thank you so much.
Hey, thank you.
In the center field, it's a base hit. That, by the way, head coach Anthony Ricci. And a single right back up the box. That's Aubrey Batts, who had fly to left field in her first at-bat.
Batts, a patient at-bat. Just squares up right back in the middle. So patient, so compact.
Number 12, Peyton Pryor.
You've got to think about the Utah team, right? They were down 3-2. Their last at-bat, the pitcher had dominated them right before this to get here. Scoring three runs in the seventh to win it 5-3. That's how they got here. Talking about the Utah-based team, they just kind of all trust one another.
Well, there's 11 on their roster. You never see that anymore. You see really deep, lots of members on the team, a lot of girls getting playing time. But when you have 11, I mean, you really are pulling a lot of weight on that team. And you also, as we mentioned earlier, have to build a lot of trust amongst each other. And this is a long, tiring, grueling event. So it takes a lot out of you, and you got to be really proud about how far this team has come and what they're able to do.
Off speed, dots the outside corner. I loved his transparency about trying to keep up with the kids and trying to run around with the big linemen and ended up injuring himself. I've been there, Coach. I've been to fantasy camp before. Yep. I've dreamt that I was once that age way back when, ended up in the cold tub for days. As that one misses outside. Yeah, heart and soul team. That's what PGF is all about. This has been such a national event now. I mean, really grown, built with that premise, but now teams from all over North America representing. More than 600 teams overall in the first 2 weeks in these 2 weeks of action at different divisions, nine total divisions. Hawaii represented, certainly teams from Hawaii north of the border in Canada. Bouncing ball snagged over there at third, recovering, fired right through the fingertips. We had a switch over there at third base, too, and I mean, just pouncing on it. This is a great reaction play at third.
Yeah, it's just a good job of knocking that ball down.
Macy Mattson had moved over there. Nora Epley will run for the catcher. Runners on second and third. Single and then a miscue allows the runner to move up.
Now batting number 24, Aubrey Wright.
Aubriello Wright. A catcher by trade. DP in this game. And takes that one just a little bit low. This is a good, good student. Carnegie Mellon, UT Martin, College of Charleston, Gettysburg, some of the schools on her list. out of Matthew and Melidia. Screwball misses inside. Nobody out. Hitters count 2-0. Base open. Two RBIs sitting right out front. Squares the bunt, takes low and inside.
You know, it's not a bad idea. A little safety squeeze possibly put on, or maybe just a show bunt to try to draw a ball. But with a runner trailing at second base.
Can we let it fly here 3-0?
I want to say yes. You're going to get a good pitch, but first base is open. And not happening.
Okay.
See how I talk myself through that pitch and I don't have to actually
make it. You played the result. That was well done by you. By the time you answered my question, you had played the result. That was well done. It's fun seeing an athlete like Aubrey get this chance, too, on a stage. She goes to a smaller school. There's only 28 kids in her grade. So for her to get this chance, small Cathedral High School, and to play on this national stage, that just speaks to her skills.
Number 8, Lily Jones.
Lily Jones now, LJ. Running fly ball center field. RBI time for Lily Jones. Come on down. The run slides in safely. An add-on run now. It's 4-1. Lily Jones with a sack fly and an RBI. 4-1.
Good job, Ben.
That's really nice contact. And deep enough. Not really a chance to get that runner going home, but that throw does go all the way through, so maybe a missed opportunity to take third base on that throw, but nothing hurt. Still two runners on base, only one out.
Addie Ware, a quick conversation with her head coach as we see Coach Anthony making a change here in the circle.
30-99.
Hannah Brockman will come on and play as well. Looks like Ella Miller will move into the circle.
Hannah Brockman on the mound.
17 is the new
Ella Miller
pitcher.
Is the new pitcher. Hannah Brockman
Ella
comes
Miller,
off the bench.
Number 17 on the mound.
And is it first base? And everything figured out. Miller, and there's Brockman. Hannah Brockman over there at first out of Taylorsville, Utah. Her first action in this game. Miller moves into the circle. Oh, the daughter of Phil and Megan. Strong right-handed pitcher. She describes herself as the following. Good speed, spin, and control. When I hit, we've seen her hit already. Righty power hitter, makes good contact. Drives in runs. So we'll watch her work in the circle now. Trying to stop it right now. You feel like there's every chance in the world this team with what they've done can come back from 4-1, but it feels different at 6-7-1.
It does, and this, because it's within one swing of the bat, and I think these teams really do believe that, and they've experienced that, how quickly a comeback can happen.
There does come a time when you've had to play so many games, and if games as well, where your body is human, and you start to get exhausted.
Addison Ware in the batter's box.
They play Addie Ware tight. She sees that one up and away. 2-0 the count. She's out of Lanesville, Indiana. She'd love to play, how about it, LSU, Kentucky, Liberty, or Florida State. Screwball missed way outside. 3-0 the count.
The Miller's still struggling to find that zone and hoping to paint that outside corner, maybe get a little ground ball to the left side.
She'll take it at 2-6-8 runner up the line, who's a great contact hitter, doesn't have to do any of that time. And the bases are loaded with the walk now.
Now batting left fielder, number 3, Caitlin Whitlock.
Caitlin Whitlock now, the daughter of Brittany and Jesse. Big sister to Kinsley, takes a strike over the outside. Kinley, I should say. Former basketball player who sports a 3.9 GPA. Bouncing ball. Easy underhand from Johnson. Flipped it on over to Brockman. You can add another one. 5-1 is the score. 4-3 for Whitlock and an RBI.
That was just really nice situational hitting to take the ball with her softly up the right side to allow that run to score.
Jayla Manning, who played varsity her 8th grade year, was a chance to play up and learn from much older players. Fouls it back to the screen. She shared it took so much to fight for a spot and then to have the bravery to play for such a competitive team. She said all my teammates were much older but very supportive. Future orthodontist hitting right now. This is outside, 1-1 the count. She makes no bones about who she loves to watch play, and that's Odyssey Alexander. Her time at James Madison, now professionally. Couldn't square up the changeup that time.
Yeah, I kept the hands back real well.
Slaps that one again, tried to stay back as long as she could. You're kind of teetering on the game's turning point because a 2-out RBI would really deflate.
Yeah, this was a nice attempt. Almost squares it up, but I think you're right, Darren. A couple more runs up on the board really kind of gives you that feeling like this is a mountain to climb rather than load the bases one swing of the bat type of a situation.
Got her. Great job at home plate, by the way, Ricky, staying on top of that one. Changed up, that one dove into the dirt at home plate. A huge strikeout for Miller when they needed it the most. Strong today for this Fusion National team. They have scored the athlete in the circle 5 runs, and she'll take advantage of that opportunity. Coming back through the years from a pretty severely broken ankle, she said that was a big, big challenge for me as she deals with Macy Madsen. Screwball dives over the inside. A right-handed pitcher that we've seen a curveball that really breaks half the plate. It's been a big part of who she's been today. Macy locked up. That's over the inside corner. 18U Platinum National Championship game coming up right on this diamond. Right after this contest, what a busy day we have tomorrow. The 16 and 18U Premier Championships, High School All-American game, the Futures game as well. Celebration of the sport. Amanda and I are honored along with our production team to bring it to you. 18U Premier game on ESPNU. Futures game you can stream on ESPN3 and then back on the ESPN family of networks at High School All-America. Oh, baby, what a changeup. Almost need an hourglass, not a radar gun to deal with that one. What a pretty pitch.
Yeah, really pulled the string on that pitch. You can see the differential in speed. This one a good 15 miles an hour off. Look at how up front Madsen is. That ball nice down in the zone.
Ainsley Quinn. Not only does it die at the plate, she spins it a little bit as well. Ranging over to the left, Madison Reed. A couple of times has made that exact play and has done it well.
Yeah, if that gets by Reed all the way to Satterley, there's no shot at first base. That has to be cut off.
Number 22, Brooklyn.
Great range coming across the diamond.
Braylee Shields, the right fielder, is 0 for 2. Shields takes strike one.
Number 7, Braylee Shields in the batter's box.
Winsett said, as far as managing time as an elite athlete, what her secret is. So it's just putting in the work. Changed up just off the plate. I asked them all, and I put the question just like this. How do you manage time? What are your secrets? She said, my secret's just putting in the work. She said, hard work beats talent. When talent doesn't, we'll always work hard. It helps me grow as a player. It helps me grow as a student. She's a completely different pitcher right now, by the way. It's all secondary stuff this inning.
Yeah, you can tell the difference that she's making, the adjustments that she's making. Winsett is in the circle with that off-speed pitch, using it very frequently. And then coming in tight.
Interesting, picked it up fair. I think that was one Peyton would tell you. Well, when I didn't get it initially, I maybe should have let it roll foul.
Yeah, I think those are one of the, if she would have just let it go, I think it would have stayed fair. I think that dirt looks pretty thick out there in front of home. Maybe didn't have enough pace, but you never know because picking it up doesn't really give you a chance either. It's just one of those tough calls. Takes a really funny hop out there in front of the plate. Just unlucky.
Brooklyn rookie, base hit. That will send the runner to third. Brooklyn reached on a fielder's choice. Also popped up to the pitcher, but now she's got herself a base hit.
I really should say unlucky depending on who you were, because that really set up this for Ricky to come through with this nice soft line drive into right field.
Behind home plate, great reaction by the way, as Pryor made the catch. Her pitcher wins it, racing in towards her, arms outstretched by her side. 5-1 the score. Utah trailing the Fusion national team. What a celebration this has been all week long for these All-Americans. It's out into the Newport Harbor on a beautiful Southern California yacht. The partnerships and the sponsorship so important, and then the gear. What a presentation. It's such an earned opportunity and a celebration, especially for the high school All-Americans. It's kind of their final celebration of this age before they go off to college.
Yeah, it was a really cool event for the family. So it wasn't just the athletes on the yacht. It was mom, dad, sister, brother, they had a chance to invite their family, and they really had a chance to be celebrated for everything that they've given to the sport and to their careers up to this point before they go off to college.
Off the mound, or off the circle, I should say. Miller makes the play quickly. Ella jumps out of there. She gets Lauren Satterley, who had had a good day, singled in a run, also reached on the fielder's choice and scored. As we play here in the bottom half of five, bottom half of inning number five.
Number six, Madison
Reed had that big two-out, two RBI single back in the first inning. That one sails high, that curveball that time. Beautiful. Nick Miller finding the shade. Dodgers fan up top finding the shade. Changeup dips in there. That got her. So Reed is on.
Barely gets the top of that
now
back foot.
Number nine, Aubrey Bats.
Good screwball, elicits a swing and a miss. That's a hitter's name, isn't it? Aubrey Bats. U national team for the Fusion. That one's lifted up and hugs the line. Still hugging. That's a fair ball. That bats plays for sure. That one just sought out green grass and found it.
Yeah, it's a nice adjustment after swinging a miss on that outside pitch before. Gets just enough of this outside pitch to land it inside the foul line. Hey, you'll take anything at this stage of the game. And I know Fusion wants a couple more runs to cross just because they know no lead is safe against a team like the Freaks.
Couple of runners on for the catcher, Peyton Pryor. 0-1 the count on Peyton. Back at home in Southern Indiana and Floyd Knobs, Indiana. This Fusion squad has a wonderful indoor practice facility. They have the same setting in Louisville, Kentucky at Assumption High School, the green. Really, really practical and helpful facilities they have indoors. They take advantage of it. That one nearly got her as that one spins in the screwball that time. There are national teams for the Fusion at the 14, 16, and 18 year age groups. Changed up on her, hugs the line. That's a foul ball. Athena turned around trying to make the tag. Madsen had moved in for a bit, playing third for a few innings. Now Tonga Navai back out there at third base. But she had so many great reaction plays early.
Now it's really been a hot spot this game over there at third. A lot of decision-making, hot shots.
And a commitment. Owen, beautiful rise to that one. Turned it over with the spin just a little bit, too.
And Miller's scouting report talks about her effective changeup and a hard bite on that rise ball. And that's just perfect location for that pitch.
Nora Epley.
Nora Epley takes her opportunity, gets a chance to hit.
Number 10.
So good chance for Nora. She's from Russellville, Kentucky. Can play in the middle of the infield, also in the outfield. Has looked at Lipscomb, has looked at Abilene Christian, Lindsey Wilson College, some places she'd like to play. Amanda and Jerry, her family. Kelby, her older sibling. Down off the end of the bat, but she drives it toward left field, up against the wall.
again. Look at her flying around. Into third off the bench with the triple. How about you, Nora?
Talking about capitalizing on an opportunity, comes in a pitch hit situation and gets this shot on the first pitch she sees. That means she's doing her homework in the dugout, timing the pitcher, and she takes this pitch all the way to the fence, clears the bases with two outs. Some clutch hitting.
Brother played college basketball at Lindsey Wilson College. She wants to play softball in college. She's a heck of a basketball player, too. She showed some great wheels flying around the bases. What a great story out there, Nora Epley. They'll look to plate her now. LJ Lily Jones. Turned it on when she saw that she had squared it up. In pandemic year of 2020, she had to have labrum surgery. Tied her up at third. And an easy chance that time for Athena in time for the out. But not before Nora got the call. Hop off the bench, see what you can do for us. How about three bases? A little comfort on the scoreboard. 7-1 in the 16U Platinum Championship. What a wonderful place it is to visit, to get on a plane, to come cool off. Southern California, the Premier Girls Fast Pitch. PGF 16U Platinum National Championship game. Based in Kentucky and Indiana, the Fusion team, but a national team. A lot of Midwestern athletes. And the Utah Freaks, a real local team and a special one with what they have accomplished. And it looks like Mia Keigel will hop into the circle. Sadie did a really good job, wins it. Her five strong innings leaves this contest leading 7-1. What'd you think of Sadie?
I just thought she did such a good job of redefining herself inning after inning to keep the Freaks off balance. I think she did a good job after that first inning or a second inning when that one run was scored to just come back and slam the door on this game.
How about that? So efficient. You see that graphic, the pitches by inning.
Now batting number two, Eliza Johnson.
Mia from Bonneville, Indiana, as she works in the circle, Heritage Hills High School. Love to play Northwestern or UConn, Notre Dame, or Southern Indiana. Daughter of Nathan and Emily. And Keigel has really done a wonderful job in the classroom, making her very recruitable. Top 3% of her class, 4.2 GPA. Looking at the wings of shoulder. That one died at the plate. What a beautiful pitch that was.
That's a gutsy pitch going down and inside. Nice drop to the lefty. We talk so much about how hard it is to hit that pitch away, lefty thrown away from a lefty, but that pitch had so much bite inside. That's tough to do anything with as well.
The drop ball is her go-to pitch. Likes her inside curve, rise and screw as well. This left-handed pitcher is 6 feet tall, so a lot of leverage he's able to use.
And a lot of room to break from the release point to the strike zone.
0-2 the count on Ella Miller. Miller singled and scored back in the second inning. Grounded out to short. Drives that one toward the alley. All the way to the wall.
ball. It will go up against that wall, a couple of bases, and a double for Ella. That's her second hit. 2 for 3.
I love that the athletes on the Freaks do a little bit of everything. So we saw Miller, look as she gets jammed. It looks like on that pitch, but has so much power and leverage through the zone. She's able to get to extension and really get that ball into left center field. But comes into pitch, does her job at the plate.
Had to miss 6 months with a broken foot, really focused on taking care of every other part of her body that she could care for. I changed my diet a little bit, really focused on working out other parts where I could gain strength as Sandoval takes high 2-0 the count. You hear that, you hate to have it happen, but you hear that from elite athletes like you and others where, okay, I'm immobile in one area, but I'm gonna make the rest of my body stronger now.
I think that's important for athletes to know, just because one part of you is injured, there's so many other ways that you can continue to keep your body in shape so that your recovery, when you're ready to come back, doesn't take as long.
3-0 the count. That's outside. Ball 4. All right, why not make it interesting? You came all this way, you've snatched some wins away, you've been the heartbreak kids.
Number 50, Athena Tonga Onavai.
Tonga Onavai. Knock one over the boards here. Make it interesting, Athena. Squaring a bunt. Creed, stand up. Give her the sign, if you don't mind, for hit a double in the gap.
I don't know, trying to load the bases? I mean, that makes it interesting as well.
Watch again.
But I want to see some fireworks.
There you go. Big swing, but it tied her up. A couple of steps back to the bag, and right on top of that bag, Lily Jones is there. There you go. 7-1 the score. They're counting down outs now. They know they need to get 4, and they are champions.
Number 24. Macy Vancey.
Macy Madsen will drive in a pair. One run, come on down, a second run. Macy in there. Single with a pair of RBIs. Now we've got something very interesting within a grand slam. It's a 7-3 game. They've actually out-hit the Fusion team.
Yeah, and a great look at the redirection on that pitch right back up the middle. A nice throw home. But that run is already too close to scoring. So a great decision to make the cut. Just a little shy of making the play at second base.
Now batting, Ainsley Quinn.
1-0 the count to Ainsley Quinn. Singled, walked, also grounded out to third. Takes right down the middle. By the way, she plays for her dad. That's her high school coach at Cypress High School. One and two, the count. .9 GPA. Got her in the elbow. She had that protective guard on, so she flips that right off as she heads to first base. No complaints, just more base runners.
Now batting right fielder, number 7.
Now going for that drop inside, you can see the spin in the ball, but the ball a little high in the zone and in tight.
We may make a change here.
Stinky man,
we'll see. Nope, just some words of encouragement.
You know, that's the beauty of being a pitcher when your team gets some runs up on the board for you. You've got a little more grace and flexibility with your pitches. You can allow a couple runs, make a few mistakes, knowing that your team's been getting it done at the plate.
Jennifer Hunt finishes her visit. One and zero the count. Two outs in the inning. Imagine what you could do if you could plate those two runners that are out there before this inning ends, as that one rolls foul. Again, they were down to their final at bat, their final batter. Down by a run in the if game, the semifinals to get here, and they won, came back more victorious. Playing with house money now. Outside. This Fusion team is 21-9 this summer, 15-3 in the month of July, hitting .352 as a team. Both move up. Well, a single now will get the job done in plating both those runs. That's big.
Yeah, the most difficult teams to face are the teams that really, truly believe that the game's never over until your last swing.
Good speed, but a timely play. Mia made it, turned it into an out. Couple of runs, make it interesting. 7-3 is the number, the PGF 16U Platinum Championship. Amanda Freed, Darren Sutton, and you, thanks for being with us. Beautiful Southern California. Using dugout there on top by four.
Yes, go up to
bat. There we go. The smiles, the minion call out. I know a lot, and I've learned a lot watching.
Hold on, let's listen.
All right, three outs, get the damage done. But the things I've learned being around Diamond Sports my whole life is she won't hit with those cups on her eyes, I promise you.
And she shouldn't.
No. Look at Freak got all serious on us. I like it.
Don't you dare.
Addie Ware has had a good day. She's stolen a bag, she's scored a run, she's drawn a walk. Beware is what they haul her from the dugout. What a fun nickname with the last name of Ware. Addie Beware. One of the younger players on this team at 2026. Be heading into her sophomore year of high school. AP courses, they were on her resume this past year, honors classes already. Slaps that one foul.
And opportunities like these, you don't forget. And once you've been on this type of stage, you don't settle for anything less. So these really are defining moments in a lot of athletes' careers. The ones that go on to do great things, they remember the turning points like this, being on this stage and really getting a taste for what that real competition feels like.
This triple threat slapper winds it back to the screen. As we told you earlier, she runs a 2.68, so flies up the line. Coming back from a snapped fibula and tibia that cost her almost 6 months of time. It really grinded my mind. It took a lot of mental toughness to just hang in there as I recovered. Screwball and a good take. Did you ever have a serious injury that sidelined you for a while?
I had a forearm injury. It didn't require surgery. I think it was frustrating not being able to do anything about it, but it did sit me out for some amount of time, which it's really tough to be patient through that recovery process and not want to come back too soon and prolong that time off.
Beware of Addie Ware. Three times she's been on base. And that sprinter's block now, ready to roll. Caitlin Whitlock. Singled, also drove in a run with the ground out in the fourth. Caitlin hits it on the line, snatches it right off the floor. Looking for two. They got two. That's a double play. Sandoval on across to Brockman for the double play. Tough break because this is well hit.
Yeah, nice hit. Almost hits the ground, and it's away from Ware, so she might be seeing that ball into the gap. Switches directions, tries to get back, but a great double play by Sandoval.
Looks like Shelby James may get an opportunity to hit.
Number 11.
Come all this way, and you want to get a chance to taste that championship action, and Shelby will get it. The pitcher outfielder, who is from Louisville Male High School from Louisville, Kentucky. I'd love to go to Murray State, Kentucky, Bellarmine, or Louisville. Daughter of Stephen and Holly James. That drop, 0-1 the count. Cross country runner. Really committed athlete physically. Also plays volleyball, plays travel volleyball. A really well-rounded athlete, honor roll student. Good patience. Not exclusively a pitcher, but pitches a ton. Very talented with a drop ball, drop curve as well, good spin. That screwball ties her up. Miller ahead, 1-2. Popped up, drifting back, put away. One last chance for the Heartbreak Utah Freaks. They've done it before. Can they do it again? They need four to play on. Premier Girls Fast Pitch 16U Platinum National Championship game. The winner of this contest plays up to the Premier Division next year. Gets a bye right into that division. As Sadie wins it, steps back into the circle looking to lock this game down. Don't forget the 18U game will follow this one. Catching us right there on flow. The Atlanta Vipers and the Colorado Stars last year. The Rock Gold out of Fort Myers, Florida won it, beating the Minnesota Renegades. This has been fun. What a great way to kick off. Both these teams have acquitted themselves nicely. Brooklyn the single, also reached on a fielder's choice. Popped up to the pitcher. Over the outside corner, 0-1 the count.
Ricky.
It's important at bat for Ricky to lead off this seventh inning and just get base runners. I mean, four runs looks like a lot, but the way that this Utah team has been swinging their bats. I mean, they've come back in ball games. They've done it recently. So this team believes that the game is not over until that last pitch is thrown, that final out is made.
Well, it's the pilot light, right? If you get that leadoff runner on, as that was a good take, it's like that pilot light that just starts to heat going. The light's a little less dim, a little less strong with one out and even more dim with two. They have so much to be proud of. 2-2, screwball just missed the inside corner. Pryor tried to hold it there as long as she could. That was a good pitch. Wow, what a pitch that was. 3-2, right back same spot. charging, fielding, firing. And did they get it? Did they get a dead ball, a foul ball? That may be the call there. It did die at home plate. So must have gotten her lead foot that time. Yeah, right off the top of her foot.
That was a great call.
Brooklyn, I give you a lot of credit. I'm not going anywhere if I pound it off my foot like that. It's a hard out to third. Another chance for Reed. She says, I'll do it again. Two outs away from a victory. Squared that one up, but Reed pounced.
Now again, over to third base, the hot spot of the day. Some really nice plays being made.
Inside corner for a strike.
In the box,
to Addison Comer. Comer singled back in the first inning, grounded out, and then popped out. That one dies just outside of the circle, one out away. Wins it, turns it into an out.
And that's right, that jump back there behind the plate for this final inning.
No batting for Utah. Number two, Eliza Johnson.
Johnson looks at a changeup that ducks the outside corner. Looking to make it a perfect 11-0 at PGF Nationals to improve to 22-9 in the summer. Popped up left side. National perfect in their visit to Southern California. They are crowned the PGF 16U Platinum National Champions. They can hit, they can field, they can pitch. And they take it back to Kentucky and Indiana, this national team. Some tears being shown. They're tired. They've really worked hard.
And they had so much to be praying for, that Pryor family. And everything they brought here to Southern California, they left it all out on the field. What a tremendous showing by the Fusion. This entire week, tears of joy and celebration, hugs all around. I mean, this is really what it's all about, and a premier berth for next year to top it off.
Congratulations to both of these teams. The Utah Freaks were down to their final breath. It was over for them. They weren't even supposed to be in this contest. And they rallied and they got it done. That means the Fusion, their program, playing in the Premier Division next year here in Southern California. Heart and soul there. I mean, really, really special who they are. There's a lot of people we could talk to down there. Sadie Winsett was important. Madison Reed singled in a couple of runs. Aubrey Batts had a couple of hits. Heck, Addie Ware got on base three times. Sadie was really good. Sadie Winsett down there was outstanding. Sadie joining us now. Sadie, congratulations. And what does this mean to be obviously named the champs?
My teammates, like, I give it all to them. It's awesome.
And your performance in the circle, I mean, it's one thing to throw leading up to this game, but when you get out there, all eyes are on you. You're throwing in a national championship. What was that feeling like?
It's awesome. I just zone it out, get in the zone, just throw my pitches.
Tell us a little bit about the human beings on your team, the teammates. What this week was like? What was this experience like?
It was awesome. I love California. I love being down here with my team. It's just amazing. All my teammates are there for me all the time.
What pitches were your best friends today? What did you really lean on?
My screwball a lot and my changeup. My curve's my best pitch, but it was not very on today, so I went to my screw and changed, and it worked.
Sadie, get it done. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Sadie Windsor joining us down below. That'll do it. And the 16U Platinum Team, they are the champions. Congratulations to these athletes. Jennifer Hunt, the head coach of that team, she gets it done. We certainly want to congratulate Anthony Ricci, the head coach of the Utah Freaks. Our entire production team, they've been here several days getting this set. All week long, we've enjoyed the athletes from the coaches banquet until today. And we're just getting started on opening weekend. The 18U Platinum Division National Championship game is coming up next. On behalf of the leadership of PGF, Amanda Freed, my name is Darren Sutton. Stick right here for titles to be handed out.